Good stuff. Good role plays. Let's talk about the topic at hand today. I thought this was something we haven't really delved into too much. A little bit of my story here. And Dave knows this. I was doing real estate, hands-on real estate, fix and flips. And Claudia and I on Super Bowl Sunday would be painting a house and getting it or doing drywall or carpet clean. We did all that stuff. And people started, and I started writing articles in a local magazine in San Diego. And people, remember Dave, Creative Real Estate Magazine? Do you remember that? Was a very popular magazine.
I
And
forgot the guy's name with the beard. What was his name?
oh my gosh. Oh, that's going to bother me all day. I'll have to look it up. It'll come to me. And people started calling me, and Claudia heard me on the phone just shooting the bull with people all day long. And the idea came, and I just told this story, I think, the other day to Frank. Basically, I decided, because my wife said, stop giving it away for free, to start charging a consult or a coaching fee. And the first person I asked when I decided to do this, and I charged a very reasonable nominal fee because I was very insecure about the whole thing, as we all are in the beginning of any new project or something. And the lady who owned real estate in Los Angeles, guess what she said when I asked her for money?
Oh,
Yes.
I didn't want to pay for it.
Yeah, I didn't want to pay for it. I wanted to take it along. I said, well, it's going to take me away from my business, my time. I cost more than a corned beef sandwich at DZ Aiken's. Great little great restaurant in San Diego, off Route 8. She paid me, and that was the beginning of a million-dollar idea that I got from my wife. I always acknowledge that. And then a lot of people didn't necessarily want coaching or stuff, but they wanted information, they wanted contracts. And so the first thing I started doing was the lease purchase packages. I do here was my book, the Lease Purchase Bible. And I started to, I put packages together. Who remembers VHS tapes? Okay.
I want to interrupt for a second. When you started making the guts package, that was basically for you. You created the system for your real estate business because you were losing deals. So when you talk about your guts package, it originally was created for your own personal use in your company, and then it took off from there.
Yeah, well, people started buying this and they bought materials. Sorry, hit the microphone. I started marketing. I did a little newsletter that we used to postal mail to people, and it had the products and everything. And this was the niche that I had out of real estate that I learned from my mentor of using options and lease purchasing. I developed the materials, I developed a newsletter because I started to get a postal list. There was a time before internet. Okay, I'm showing my age right now. Okay, internet is really, how old is the internet really? 25 years? When did it start? Early 90s? Something like that. So I took the niche of lease purchasing, just an area of real estate, created products, created a newsletter, started marketing it, and it grew the it grew and grew it's so that it funded my real estate investing. It brought in a great deal of cash flow, passive income. It allowed us to move out of, because when you think about real estate, sometimes it's feast and famine. I talk about that. You'll do a deal, but maybe you won't do another deal right away. And if you have overhead and marketing costs and employees and an office and everything, you got to feed that alligator. The informational products that I did with lease purchasing fed that alligator, got us out of debt, and it was the beginning. And this is like 30 something years ago I started this. I saw the next problem was sales, and I developed a gut sales packet. I developed the gut sales system. And I did the same thing, materials, building up the email list. Then, as the internet was growing, I put out more content, articles, then the video started happening. And I just did the same thing with attraction marketing. So, the key is, Can you pick out a niche? How do you select the niche that you want? If you just, for most of you in real estate, if you just say, I want to consult or coach or do products just on real estate, is that going to get the attraction that you want? Is that really a niche per se?
Got to be more specific.
Yeah, it's got to, you've got to niche it down. What do we mean? What do we mean by the niche? Something, how do we select? You got to pick something you're passionate about. Is it interesting to the marketplace? If you have an idea for a niche or a coaching or consulting business, can you Google it first? One of your little secrets. Are other people doing the same or similar business? Are they successful at it? Can you take that same, maybe a business that they're doing, but put a new spin on it, something unique on it, to make it unique? That's the best word. Are you the first or are you the 41st on this particular niche? On it. Does anyone have a particular niche they're thinking of or want to talk about?
With my dog training company, I don't want to be a regular dog trainer listed with everybody else. I'm trying to differentiate myself that my I'm a specialist rather than just a general practitioner. So my focus is on aggression and reactivity rehab. That's about 90%+ of the reasons people call it a trainer is their dog is fear aggressive or reactive on leash.
But how do you niche it? How do you niche a specific area of dog training? If you just say dog training, and there's 10,000 dog trainers in San Diego.
Exactly.
How do you niche it down? Maybe you just want to work with Chihuahuas or something like that. No, okay. Well, maybe there's something the non-aggressive is. I don't know the dog business. I just make jokes about Chihuahuas all the time. But is there some way you can target in on a unique aspect of dog training? We come to your house. We're the mobile dog trainer. You don't have to travel and meet us or go to the park. We'll come to your home and work with your dog. Something unique about that. Can you market that niche? Okay. The six C's, content. Is it unique? Do you have a good title when you do your marketing? Do you have interesting three secrets of how to train your dog in the next 24 hours? You know, something like that. Is it compelling? Is it attract people? Do people see this title and they click on it and say, let me go to this? Is it contemporary? Does it relate to today's needs?
Hey, Claude.
Go ahead, Brent.
Hey guys. Hey, everyone. Claude, thanks for letting me interrupt. Something for Dave is, there's a tool called SEM Rush, and there's also some free keyword tools that you can see what people are searching for on YouTube, like how to train my dog or three reasons my dog is aggressive, and start creating videos around what people are searching for. And that's going to get you so much business. I mean, I always think of Cesar on TV, that dog trainer, but if you start doing videos of you training other people's dogs and, oh, how do I do the videos? Well, hire a 7-year-old to film you while you're doing it. My 7-year-old son does some of the filming for me now. And you just post short videos just like Claude does as well. And have those keywords. That needs to be your title. And then talk about, hey guys, I'm going to talk about the three ways to get your dog to stop biting the mailman today. And then show a video of you doing your services and book a call with me, like Dave, like that. Like if you're not shooting videos and blowing up YouTube with that, you're really missing out on a bunch.
What did you call it to see what? Yeah. CSM or what?
Google free keyword search, or if you really are serious about it, you could pay for SEM Rush. That's Sierra Echo Mike, SEM Rush. But that's all I did to start my YouTube channel. We just Googled and searched what people were searching for, and I created videos around that had to do with land. And that's how I get a tremendous amount of leads from people wanting to learn land.
Brent, what are some of the terms or titles you use for land? I mean, if we just say land, that's pretty macro.
Macro.
How do we what are some of the terms you do to micro the land down?
Yeah. how to wholesale your first land deal today. And this is what people were searching for. Top 10 people weren't really searching for that. I found a smoking hot video online where someone did the top 10 ways to buy land. And then I recreated the video. But it was simple things like how to buy your first piece of land, how to buy land to build on, how to, and put your keyword in, how to train your dog, how to, you know, I'm trying to think of like, you know, how to find probate leads, how to search probate, how to get through probate. That person might not be interested in buying your list. They actually might need a probate attorney. So yeah. It's just putting yourself in the shoes of searching how to, you know, put your niche in that, how to add your niche. And then look up the keywords.
I was thinking something Brent said just for you, Dave, how to get your dog to stop barking. Nobody wants a dog that barks all day long. Okay. There's gotta be a market that you micro it down to just that little segment. You take a 10,000 dog owners. What is 10% of them have problems with dogs barking, or Hava with her lists? What is something you can do unique in your marketing about lists? There's a lot of list sellers out there. What's unique about your list, or what kind of the three secrets of a good list? How to, you know, make more money in 1 year from one good prospect, something like that. Frank, you're just starting your business right now. What would be a good niche? You want to do fix and flips. I read your email. Could you niche? There's a lot of people who say fix and flips. Could you niche that down a little bit? How to upgrade? How to make a property beautiful with a $500 budget in Home Depot? So anything like that, you know? What do you think?
That's something I've been thinking about because it's so broad. And even as we were talking, I was sitting there thinking the thought that came to mind, it was more new construction related, but the idea being, well, how do you build a house? In what order do you do things? And I was like, you know, there's several ways you could go about it.
How about the problems inherently that people have? That can you talk about the pains or the problems or the main issues that are contemporary to today or something in the news that relates? And can you put those topics out there? Can you create products? Even like I did here when I first started, I grabbed a few of these. You know, I did books. I like to write short books or novellas and things like that. And people read these, you can give them away, do whatever you want, and just keep attracting people in these different niche areas. Absolutely. Thank you, Brent, and everybody else for sharing that. I believe in giving incentives to people too, tying in, not just putting out content in your niche, but then creating incentives. You know, we're in a very, very competitive world. Trust is a big issue out there for all of us right now. Okay, so how do we get somebody to know us, to realize that we're a good person, a real person in our particular niche? Give them a reward, give them an incentive, give them something else if they trust you with their email or their phone number. This is how you're putting out content, and then in your content, you always give something else. A reward.
I was going to say, Claude, Frank can make an electronic booklet, like a free giveaway booklet handout, and he doesn't even have to print them. He can just do them and put it on his site. You know, contact me like you do for a freebie and give away a booklet on how to build a house from A to Z, the steps, and do it in like 12 pages. And just give it away as a free report.
You always want to, you have to imagine in a competitive world where people, I see web pages and things, and people are, I always make the joke, before you kiss me, you got to buy me a drink. They're just saying, trust me, give me your contact information. How do most of us feel when we go to a strange web page or somebody and you're scrolling and give us your email and everything? I think a lot of people, tell me if I'm wrong, are reluctant to share information with strangers online. True? So how do you earn that trust? You keep giving that information, consistency. You give them something, a reward, Okay, so they have an incentive to give you that contact information. Then you tie it into a scheduling calendar. That's what I do. Say, hey, if you have questions, if you'd like to pick my brain for 15 minutes, what happens through all these steps if they buy they and you get them on video? What is the statistical math? Is it in your favor? I think so. Absolutely. So it's a step-by-step process. Creating that niche in your field, though, you can, and then creating products and then leading it to coaching or consulting on it. This is exactly what I did with three different topics: real estate, lease purchase, gut sales training, which I saw as a major problem for most people in business. They don't have a system. They're kind of winging it and just throwing a lot of intellectual gobbledygook against the wall. I did the same thing with attraction marketing. In the future, I'm working for 2024. I've got other gut 6.0. That's going to be hypnotic selling, a consulting and coaching program, kind of taken from what we're talking about today. I like to write business novels, short novellas. People read my books. I sell them really cheap, $25. So besides giving away things, you can sell products, and that can lead to that one-on-one with that person. This is basically how one person with a little ingenuity, a little creativity, this is how you can create a million-dollar business, tying in unique aspects of things that you're passionate about. Time's really going fast here. You guys have any, I see there's some stuff in the chat room here. Search free word keyword on Google. Good. How to build a house from start to finish. SEM rush. Okay. Thank you for putting that in there. Is anyone here working on a niche business or would like to develop a products and coaching business, for their ideas, right?